grant all rights and privileges. It doesn't matter. Or a Gentile, black, or white, to be a new creature, born again by the Spirit of God. I'm telling you, I'm a simple man, and everybody born of women, born of sin. Everybody's conceived and sin is born of sinner. You're not a good person. The whole idea that man is good is something a simple man concocted to justify himself. You're not good. Man has no goodness in him. Man is corrupt through and through. Through and through. Throughout. Thoroughly throughout. Wickedness and evil motives of man's hearts are impure. That means you're selfish. You seek your own glory. Your own good. Without Jesus Christ, everything, every act you take is for your own glory. God is good. God alone is good. Get that. Realize that. God is good. God is good. In God's goodness, because of His grace, through the power of His grace, in the person alone of Jesus Christ,
amen,
man reconciled to the Father.
Amen.
Jesus Christ, propitiation for our sins. He fully satisfies the wrath of God against sin and sinners. You understand? Because God is good and man's a sinner. God is angry with the wicked every day. He pours out His wrath upon sin and sinners. You need someone to stand in that gap for you. You need something to happen. Because no man is going to stand before God on his own. Nobody without Jesus Christ will ever see the Father. And if you try to stand before Him on your own, you'll be like they were of old, consumed by the fire. Tossed in the fire, as Jesus says. For the worm does not die and the fire is never quenched. That means it's a place of forever.
Amen.
Understand what the good news of Jesus Christ is, because the wrath of God abides on all men who don't believe in the Son. You have to have somebody to be the propitiation for your sins. You have to have an atonement for your sins. What is it? If man is not good, no deed of man qualifies as an atonement or as propitiation. But God, that's always a key phrase in the scriptures, but God. It says in Ephesians 2, but God, who is rich in mercy, the great love with which He loved us, while we were still in our sin and dead in our sins. We were just breathing, we were dead. While we were dead in our sins,